Here's a puzzle that you can do right now. I'm going to ask you to imagine how to make something work. My 3D printed solutions to this puzzle are back there. I'll show them after the spoiler break. Okay, let me explain the puzzle. If you've got a rigid object, like this cube for example, then it has 6 degrees of freedom. You can move it along 3 spatial dimensions. Left, right, forward, backward, and up, down. You can also rotate it around 3 perpendicular axes. So this cube has 6 degrees of freedom if it's just floating in space. If, however, we were to encase the cube in a block of concrete, it would have 0 degrees of freedom. It would be unable to move or rotate in any direction unless you move the block of concrete around. So really the cube would have 0 degrees of freedom relative to the block of concrete. That's the right way to say it. All right, here's the puzzle. How can you design 2 rigid shapes that fit together somehow, so that relative to one of the shapes, the other has precisely 1 degree of freedom? Or 2 degrees of freedom, how would you do that? Or 3, 4, or 5? 6 degrees of freedom is easy, the 2 shapes aren't touching each other at all, so they can move however they want, and we've already done 0 degrees of freedom with the block for concrete. If you already get what I'm asking, pause the video now and have a think about it. Otherwise, let me give you one more example that has 1 degree of freedom. This is a wheel on an axle. These are 2 rigid bodies, and relative to the axle, the wheel has precisely 1 degree of freedom. All it can do is rotate around the axle. Let's ignore the wobble. So, after the spoiler break, how to do 2 degrees of freedom, or 3, or 4, or 5. Let's start with 3 degrees of freedom. So here I've got a spherical shell in the shape of a dodecahedron, and inside there's a ball. And this ball can rotate in 3 different directions. It has the full range of motion of any rotation, it just can't translate at all. So that's 3 degrees of rotational freedom. For 4 degrees of freedom, we can do the same sort of thing, but just allow a little bit of translational motion. So here, I've got a ball inside of a torus. For 5 degrees of freedom, we can do the same thing, except that rather than being inside of a torus, the ball is trapped between 2 planes. Again, it can rotate any which way it wants, but also it can translate in 2 different dimensions. Finally, here's a solution for 2 degrees of freedom. This is like the wheel on the axle, except that now the axle is itself a circle, so the wheel can either rotate like a wheel around the axle, or it can rotate around the axle the other way. What solutions did you come up with? Let me know in the comments below. Really, we're talking about the dimension of the configuration space. To talk about where the wheel is relative to the axle, you just need to know one number, the angle it's at. Or rather, you need to know a point on a circle. The configuration space for the wheel relative to the axle is that circle. In a similar way, you need 2 angles for the 2 degrees of freedom solution, and the configuration space is a torus. For the ball in a sphere, you need 3 numbers, and it turns out that the configuration space is a 3-dimensional manifold named SO3. The solutions for 4 and 5 degrees of freedom have 4 and 5-dimensional manifolds for their configuration spaces. There's something unsatisfying about my solution for 5 degrees of freedom. The configuration space has a boundary. When the ball is on the side like this, you lose at least 1 dimension. Is there a solution with 5 degrees of freedom that doesn't have a boundary? One last puzzle for you. Is it possible to come up with a mechanism which has exactly 2 rotational degrees of freedom? The wheel and axle has 1 degree of freedom. The ball in a sphere has 3. But can you get 2? Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.